Coordination, the linking system. Introduction. Sharpening of a pencil, grasping a doorknob, walking or running, and a few physical actions all involve well-coordinated movements made with well-balanced postures. In fact, whenever move the three basic functions, such as movement, balance, and coordination, they work together to perform purposeful motions of body parts. This is actually quite a feat because moving is a complex process for the body. All our functions are carried out by an effort of several systems working together. Example, while movement, we hardly ever use just the skeletal system or muscular system alone. Several other systems also have their own roles to play. Responding to stimuli. Stimulus is a thing or event that causes a specific functional reaction in an organ or tissue. All living organisms respond to stimuli. Example, the cat may be running because it saw a mouse. Plants grow towards the sunshine. There is a sequence of events that brings about response. They start from detecting changes in environment or stimuli, transmission of the information, processing of the same. Finally, the response will detect and execute the appropriate action. Activity. Holding a falling stick. Take a long scale or stick at least around 1/2 meter. Keep your fingers in holding position as shown in figure. To hold the stick or scale near the end and let the other end can be suspended between your fingers. Let there be a very small gap around 1 centimeter between thumb and the stick or scale and forefinger. Could you hold it exactly at the point where it was suspended between your fingers? No. How far up was this point from the end suspended between your fingers? It is just about the point from the fingers. Why did this happen? Because the time taken for stimulus, that is leaving the stick, and the response of the nervous system. How fast do you think the process was? It is within fraction of second. Responses are brought about by rapid changes in some muscles, and such changes are usually to changing stimuli. Integrating pathways. Nervous coordination. The Greeks believed that all functions of the body were controlled by the brain. Since damage to that organ produced remarkable changes in behavior. Galen, a Greek physiologist between 129 to 200 AD, made a notable observation. One of his patients, having suffered a blow on the neck when falling from his chariot, complained of loss of feeling in the arm while still retaining normal muscular control of its movement. Galen concluded that nerves were of two kinds, those of sensation and those of action. According to him, the blow in the neck had damaged the nerves of sensation but had not affected its action. The functioning of nerves as integrating systems was little known till late 18th century. Then, physiologists began to study the mechanism of nerve functioning and found how signals were transmitted by making the connection between recent work on electricity and the propositions working of the nervous system made till then. Structure of nerve cell. Activity. Neuron is a highly specialized cell which is responsible for transmission of nerve impulses. The neuron consists of the following parts: cyton or cell body, dendrites, axon and axon terminal. Cyton or cell body. The cell body or cyton is somewhat star-shaped with many hair-like structures protruding out of the margin. Cell body consists of prominent nucleus. Nasal granules are present in cytoplasm of cell body. The hair-like structures are called dendrites. Dendrites receive nerve impulses. The long projection that extends from cell body is axon and is surrounded by myelin sheath. The myelin sheath is made up of Schwann cells and chiefly consists of fatty material. It insulates the axon against nerve impulses from the surroundings. Axon ends in several hair-like structure called axon terminals. The axon terminals relay nerve impulses to dendrites or cytons of other neurons. The axon-axon-axon-dendrite connections help the neurons to transmit or relay information from one neuron to the other. The information is passed either in the form of chemical or electrical signals or both. Pathways from stimulus to response. The holding stick that there is coordination between eye and finger. Different pathways are taken by nerves to bring about this coordinated activity. On the basis of pathways followed, nerves are classified mainly into three different types. Efferent neurons. Efferent, which carry messages towards the central nervous system from nerve endings on the muscles of different sense organs that sense the change in surroundings, are called stimulus detectors. These are also called as sensory nerves. Efferent neurons. Efferent, which carry messages from the central nervous system to parts that shall carry out the response or the effectors. They are also called motor nerves. Association nerves. Association nerves, which link together the efferent and efferent nerves. Efferent nerves, brain or spinal cord. Efferent nerves, muscles of the organ. Association nerves. Activity. Our body would also need to respond to certain situations on which we may not have a control. Such responses are called reflexes. Knee-jerk reflex. The knee-jerk reflex is also called monosympathetic reflex because there is only one synapse in the circuit needed to complete the reflex. It only takes about milliseconds between the tap and the start of the leg kick. For the knee-jerk reflex, cross the legs in a seated position so that the lower half of the uppermost leg hangs freely over the other. Strike the area below the kneecap sharply while firmly grasping the front part of the thigh with the other hand. Note the changes in the shape of the thigh muscles. Although we are fully conscious, we cannot prevent the thigh muscles from contracting. Such a response is said to be involuntary. The same thigh muscles can operate in a voluntary manner, as when we kick a football. The reflex arc, the structural and functional unit that carries out reflex action, is called reflex arc. Reflex arc consists of a receptor, a sensory nerve, an association neuron, motor nerve, and an effector organ. Receptor receives information about stimuli and generates electrical potentials. The sensory nerves is associated with the receptor. It carries the information from the receptor organ to the spinal cord. In the spinal cord, the sensory nerve makes connections with other neurons in the gray matter. These neurons are called interneurons or association neurons. Association neurons process the information and generate responses. The efferent fibers of motor nerves carry these responses from interneurons to the effector organs, which is usually a muscle. The voluntary and involuntary actions in our body are controlled by nervous system as a whole. Study our nervous system on the basis of areas from which nerves originate and then spread out of the whole body as mainly two divisions, one central nervous system and other is peripheral nervous system. Central nervous system, CNS. Central nervous system includes brain and spinal cord. It coordinates all neural functions. Brain. The brain is present in the hard bony box-like structure called cranium. It is covered by three layers called the meninges. The meninges are continuous and cover the spinal cord as well. The space between the inner layers is filled with fluid called cerebrospinal fluid. It serves as a shock-absorbing medium and protects the brain against shocks or jerks along with the meninges and cranium. Mainly, the nerve cell bodies together with capillaries form a mass called gray matter, while the myelinated axons or those covered by fatty sheets form white matter. The gray matter is usually present on the periphery, white matter is present towards the center. This is mainly due to the fact that there is a small area from the myelinated axons lead the brain. The function of the brain as a control center was known nearly 2000 years back by Greek physiologists. Brain has the following divisions: forebrain, cerebrum, diencephalon, midbrain, optic lobes, hindbrain, cerebellum, medulla. Functions of the various parts of the brain. Part of the brain. Functions. Cerebrum, seat of mental abilities, controls thinking, memory, reasoning, perception, emotions, and speech. Interprets sensations and responds to cold, heat, pain, and pressure. Diencephalon, relay center for sensory impulses such as pain, temperature, and light. Reflex center for muscular activity. Center for certain emotions such as anger. Center for water balance, blood pressure, body temperature, sleep, and hunger. The hypothalamus controls the pituitary gland, which functions as the master gland. Midbrain. It relays motor impulses from the cerebral cortex to the spinal cord and relays sensory impulses from the spinal cord to the thalamus. Reflexes for sight and hearing. Cerebellum. Maintains posture, equilibrium, and muscle tone. Coordinates voluntary movements initiated by cerebrum. Medulla oblongata. Contains center for cardiac, respiratory, and vasomotor activities. Coordinates reflexes like swallowing, coughing, sneezing, and vomiting. Spinal cord. Spinal cord is a long and cylindrical structure. It passes through vertebral column, extending all along the dorsal surface of trunk. In other words, vertebrae of the vertebral column protect the spinal cord from injuries. In the cross section of the spinal cord, the gray matter appears like butterfly or in the shape of letter H. Each segment of the H-shaped gray matter is called a horn. The upper horns are called dorsal horns and the lower horns are called ventral horns. In the middle of the energy matter is a canal called spinal canal. It runs all along the length of spinal cord and is filled with cerebrospinal fluid. From the sides of spinal cord, 31 pairs of nerves take their origin and supply branches to various parts of the body. Peripheral nervous system. The peripheral nervous system consists of nerves that arise from the brain and spinal cord and a vast system of dorsal and ventral root nerve cell heads. The peripheral nervous system has 43 pairs of nerves. Of these, 12 pairs are called cranial nerves and the rest of 31 pairs are called spinal nerves. Nerves attached to the spinal cord have two types of connections or roots, one to the back of the dorsal side and other to the front or the ventral side of cord. The peripheral nervous system can either involuntarily control several functions of regions like our internal organs, blood vessels, smooth and cardiac muscles, so it is called autonomous nervous system. Coordination without nerves. The story of insulin. In Latin, insula means as island. In 1868, Paul Langerhans of Germany, working on the structure of pancreas, found isolates of Langerhans, specialized cells richly supplied with blood vessels. But the function of pancreas remained unknown. Many others interested in the functioning of pancreas found that its removal from the body of an experimental animal would lead to the development of disease called sugar or diabetes. Diabetes is a condition in which the amount of free sugar in the blood and in the urine is abnormally high. Later, scientists found that when they tied the pancreatic duct that emerged from the duodenum caused the degeneration of pancreas but not islets of Langerhans. Moreover, the animal would not develop diabetes. This was really a strong evidence that the level of blood sugar is linked with the islet cells. By 1912, workers were convinced that the islets produced a secretion which directly liberated into the blood. 10 years later, in Toronto, Banting, Best and MacLeod finally succeeded in extracting insulin from degenerate animal pancreas whose ducts to the intestine had been tied. Insulin is now produced in large quantities for the treatment of human sufferers from sugar diabetes, to whom it is administered by injection into the skin. Other chemical coordinators. The evidence that events occurring in one part of the body could be affected and indeed controlled by substances circulating in the blood was now overwhelming. In 1905, the English physiologist Starling coined the term hormone for such secretions. The glands secreting hormones were termed ductless glands since they have no tube or duct to carry away their products, which pass straight into the blood. In this way, they differ from glands such as the liver and pancreas, whose secretions pass down ducts, which are connected to other organs. The human body contains many other ductless glands. Glands do not produce their hormones at a steady rate. The adrenal gland, example, normally has a low output. The rate of heartbeat increases, the breath rate will be faster, blood pressure increases, the hair on the body becomes erect and we get goosebumps. The other things we might not observe are pupil dilation, skin becomes more sensitive, and rarely the bladder and the rectum may be emptied. Feedback mechanism. The amount of adrenaline hormone increases in the blood sharply in a frightening situation, getting anger or excited. Anger is always short-lived factor. The increased levels of adrenaline are responsible for anger. The levels of adrenaline in the blood come down slowly to normal state. The adrenaline levels persist for a longer period of time. Regular metabolic activities are disturbed. Increase in adrenaline levels leads to anger. Decrease in adrenaline levels leads to normal position. Similarly, the sugar levels in the blood rise than normal level. They are detected by the cells of pancreas, respond by producing more insulin into the blood. If the sugar levels come back to normal level, secretion of insulin is automatically reduced. So it is necessary that the hormones are secreted by the glands in our body in precise quantities are required for the normal function of the body. This means that there should be some mechanism to regulate the production. The timing and amount of hormones released by endocrine glands is controlled by the feedback mechanism, which is inbuilt in our body. None of the systems, whether nervous or chemical, are totally exclusive of each other. Endocrine glands. Name of the gland. Location. Hormone secreted. Response of body to hormone. Pituitary. Floor of brain. Somatotrophin. Growth of bones. Thyrotrophin. Activity of thyroid gland. Gonadotrophin. Activity of ovary and testis. Adrenocorticotrophic hormone stimulates secretion from adrenal cortex. Luteinizing hormone. In males, secretion of testosterone. In female, ovulation, development of corpus luteum and secretion of progesterone. Follicle stimulating hormone. In male, spermatogenesis. In female, growth of graafian follicles, estrogen secretion, milk production and secretion. Thyroid. Neck. Thyroxine. General growth rate and metabolic activity. Ovary. Lower abdomen. Estrogen. Growth of the uterus and skeleton of the pelvis. Control of the 28 days menstrual cycle in females. Testes. Scrotal sac. Testosterone. Growth of hair on face. Muscular development. Depending of voice. Normal sexual behavior and development of male sex organs. Adrenal. Attached to kidneys. Adrenaline. Increase in heartbeat rate. Rise in blood sugar. Dilation of the coronary artery. Dilation of the pupil of the eye. Autonomous nervous system. The peripheral nervous system that controls involuntary functions of the body is known as autonomous nervous system. It has voluntary control of muscles of some areas of skin and the skeletal muscle. Example, when we enter a dark room, we cannot see anything immediately. Slowly, we are able to see things around us in the room. This is because of increase to diameter of pupil, which allows more light in. When we come out of the dark room into the broad daylight, the diameter of the pupil decreases, allowing less light to enter into the eyes. Both these functions occur under the influence of the autonomous nervous system. To which organs of the body do the nerves go from the ganglions near the vertebral column? Eyes, salivary glands, heart, lungs, liver, stomach, gallbladder, intestine, adrenal gland, sex organs. Which are the organs that receives nerves starting from the brain? Nose, eye, tongue, ear, head, neck and shoulder. Which are the organs whose activities are influenced by the sympathetic system? Eyes, lungs, kidneys, gastrointestinal tract, heart, stomach, sweat glands, sex organs, adrenal gland, salivary glands. Which are the organs whose activities are influenced by the parasympathetic system? Eyes, lungs, kidneys, gastrointestinal tract, heart, stomach, sweat glands, sex organs, adrenal gland and salivary glands. What do you understand about the functions of parasympathetic system? The major functioning of parasympathetic nervous system is to keep the body in its normal state, and it is called as rest and digestive system or feed or breathe system. Control mechanisms in plants. How do plants respond to stimuli? Activity. Touch the leaves of Mimosa pudica, Atipathi, touch me not plant, and observe the response of leaves. Mimosa pudica leaves had pad-like swelling at the base called pulvini. Here cells contain lot of water and large intercellular spaces. Due to water pressure, pulvini hold the leaf erect. When we touch the leaves, as electrical impulse is generated. The impulse acts on plant hormone. Because of this hormone, water in the pulvini cells, which are closer to the leaf vein, migrate to other side of the cell. Then pulvini lost its firmness, hence leaves become cold. After 20 to 30 minutes, water becomes back, pulvini attains firmness, and leaves become erect. Touch me not plant shows gnostic movement by touch. Situations where we may see plants responding to a certain stimulus. The tendrils of plants growing towards a support by touch. Thigmotropism, example, cucumber and bitter gourd. Roots growing towards water, hydrotropism. Roots grow downwards in the direction of gravity, geotropism. Shoots of the plant grows towards light, phototropism. Dandelion flower opens the petals in bright light during the daytime. Dandelion flower closes the petals at night. Moon flower closes the petals during the daytime. Hormones. Uses. Abscisic acid. Closing of stomata, see dormancy. Auxins, cell elongation and differentiation of shoots and roots. Cytokinins, promote cell division, promotion of sprouting of lateral buds, delaying the aging in leaves, opening of stomata. Ethylene, ripening of fruit. Gibberellins, germination of seeds and sprouting of buds, elongation of stems, stimulation of flowering, development of fruit, breaking the dormancy in seeds and buds. Activity. Take a glass jar and fill with soil. Take a bean seed near the wall of the jar. This helps us to observe how root and shoot are growing. After 4 to 5 days, we will notice seed germination. Keep the jar under the sun. Roots grows downwards into the soil and shoot grows towards the light. Then tilt the glass jar and keep the plant horizontally on its side as shown in the figure. In this position, the roots and stem both are parallel to the ground. Allow the plant to grow in this position for 4 to 5 days. Observation. After a few days, we will find that roots of the potted plant bend downward towards the soil and the stem of the plant bend upwards away from the earth. The roots of plant grow downwards in the response to the pull of gravity. The stem of plant responds to gravity in the opposite way by growing upwards towards the light and away from the pull of gravity. In 1926, the Dutch plant physiologist F.W. Wendt succeeded in separating this influence from the plant that produced it. Wendt cut off coleoptile tips from oat seedling, tips on a slice of agar and left them for about a hour. He then cut the agar into smaller blocks and placed a block on one side, each stump of the decapitated plants. They kept in the dark during the entire experiment. Within 1 hour, he observed a distinct bending away from the side on the agar block was placed. agar block that had not been in contact with collectile tip produced either no bending or only a slight bending toward the side on which the block had been placed. The collectile tip exerted its effect by means of chemical stimulus rather than a physical stimulus, such as an electrical impulse. This chemical stimulus came to be known as auxin. Tropic and nastic movements in plants. The movement of individual parts of a plant is possible subjected to external stimuli. This type of response is called tropism, a tropic movement. Sometimes, the direction of movement may be determined by direction of stimuli. This type of response is called nastic movement. The growth of a creeper plant near window. The shoots of creeper bend towards sunlight. Such type of response of a plant to light is called phototropism. The roots always grow downwards. The plants respond positively for gravitational force. This is called geotropism. Plants grow near a rock or wall side. All roots are growing in one direction, away from the rock or wall, where water is available in the soil. This type of response to the water is called hydrotropism. Plants in movement of tendrils. All plants show positive response to phototropism. But in creepers like cucumber, bitter gourd, the stem is weak and thin. Hence, plant cannot grow erect. Tendrils play a vital role to make the plant erect. Tendrils are thin thread-like growths on the leaves or stems of climbing plant. They grow towards support and ring around them. This type of response to make contact or touch is called thigmotropism, or the directional growth movement of plant part in response to the touch of an object is called thigmotropism. The movement of plant part in response to chemical stimulus is called chemotropism.